Before there was Chrono Trigger, Secret of Mana, and even Final Fantasy IV, there was Drakkhen. It was officially the first role-playing game on the SNES, released in 1991 when the system was still young. At the time, I was a young RPG enthusiast that had played and replayed the Final Fantasy and Dragon Quest games on the NES. When I picked up this title way back then, I was super excited to see what the SNES could offer for RPGs. And well, as it turned out, Drakkhen was a mixed bag. One of the things I liked about this game was that you have the power to craft a customized group of four different characters from the start. The class options are Fighter, Scout, Magician, and Priest, and just like any RPG, they all have their strengths and weaknesses. In this way, it was like a more limited version of the original Final Fantasy game, but Drakkhen does let you allocate skill points in various combinations as well. I like this concept because of the customization. Your party truly became your own. Drakkhen is an adventure game, but with some RPG elements thrown in. That's about the best way I can describe it. It reminds me quite a bit of the old King's Quest titles for the PC, but it is more RPG-oriented than those games. When you first play this one, you can't help but realize that much of it focuses on exploration and discovery. The maps are large, and you are forced to go from place to place with little to no direction. Also, it's very easy to stumble upon ridiculously powerful enemies by accident, just by wandering too far away from where you're supposed to be. The menu to control your actions is on the right-hand side of the screen, and this is how you can get information about your surroundings, pick up objects and items, and attack enemies. The combat is just weird and quirky, and Drakkhen essentially plays itself in all the battles. The results are determined by the power of your items and how you allocated your skill points at the beginning of the game, but I just wish you were given more control over what happens. It's hard to track your progress against enemies, and you just don't get to make many strategic decisions that benefit you. It just isn't as rewarding as one would expect a game like this to be. Another thing that just sucks is that instead of a typical RPG where experience points are divided among the party, in Drakkhen only the party member that lands the finishing blow on the monster receives the benefit. This forces the player to have to go to stupid lengths, like placing non-damage spells on all but one character, just so experience is evenly divided. It's utterly frustrating. To make your way through Drakkhen, you have to discover dungeons and castles, find special items, and defeat powerful monsters. In the castle areas, there are usually many rooms to explore, with secret passages and basic puzzles to solve. Unfortunately though, you really don't get many good hints about where to go, and even when you do, the clues themselves are often unclear. Sometimes you get an actual cardinal direction, like we do from this weird dragon dude here, but not always. If I called it convoluted, that might be a charitable description. The story of the game is hard to fully decipher, but it revolves around collecting blue artifacts called tears. You and your party's goal is to prove your worth to Drakkhen, who will spare his wrath on the troubled Drakkhonian people if his tears can be returned. Apparently, the game was originally created in French, then translated into Japanese, and then translated into English. As a result, many of the particulars of the lore seem to have been obscured, and we are just left with a lot of confusion. It sounds weird, but there were some moments in this game that actually startled me back in the day. For instance, as you approach this column, a green lizard-like monster just jumps out and threatens you out of nowhere. Also, some of the enemy attack animations are downright creepy and a bit humorous. Even though some of the sound effects are super odd and frankly out of place, I did think the music was actually very well done. It won't blow you away like some of the best RPG soundtracks on the system or anything like that, but the songs fit the fantasy theme pretty well. Drakkhen was originally developed for the Amiga and Atari ST, so the graphics aren't much better than an NES game. However, that really isn't what bothers me most about it. The gameplay is just brutal. I really, really wanted to like this game, and on the surface it seemed like the right game for me. The role-playing theme and fantasy setting were definitely to my fancy, but this game just fell flat. This opinion may be controversial to some though, because I know this is a polarizing game. I found several people that just love it, but I can't pick this one up and play it like I can a true RPG classic of the era. The few things I liked were overshadowed by lackluster gameplay, and it's just too bad. I was disappointed with this game in 1991, but thankfully Final Fantasy IV was just around the corner back then. The good thing is that a better sequel to this game was released years later. In Japan, it was called Super Drakkhen, but in the United States it was released as Dragon View in 1994. Apparently, the Kemco marketing team wanted to get away from the stigma of the Drakkhen name, and I really can't blame them for that. Even if you don't like Drakkhen at all, don't skip out on Dragon View. that one is very good. It has some similarities, but it went to a fully action RPG format, and it really worked well. If you like this review and remember Drakkhen, leave a comment below about the most memorable aspect of the game to you. If you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel and click the bell below to be alerted upon the addition of new ones. Also, please consider supporting my channel via YouTube's Join feature to receive member exclusives, such as advanced videos and complete video transcripts.